The Eagles enter Sunday night's game against the Dallas Cowboys 8-1, coming off a bye week and sitting atop both the NFC East and the NFC playoff standings. But in all reality, the season starts on Sunday night. Yes, the Eagles are 8-1, and you can't take anything away from what they've been able to do. They've beaten the teams they're supposed to beat. They blew out the Denver Broncos, who looked really pedestrian despite having the number one defense coming into their game 2 weeks ago. They took care of business against the Giants. They survived at the last minute. They went on the road and beat the Carolina Panthers, who were arguably their toughest competition through the first half of the season. But you look at the second half, beginning on Sunday night against Dallas, in a game where the Eagles are more talented, they're deeper, the Cowboys are affected by the loss of Sean Lee, Tyron Smith, and certainly Ezekiel Elliott. Really no reason they should lose this game, and if they lose it, I think you can look at it as stumbling out of the gate coming off the bye. But their opponents in the second half have a combined record of 31-32. That's a little bit skewed because they play the 1-8 Giants in week 16, but you have to go to LA, you have to go to Seattle, back to back. You start off the second half of the season after the bye against the Cowboys. You have to play the Oakland Raiders on Christmas night. These are difficult games. These are difficult teams. This is playoff caliber competition for the most part. And I remember talking in Carolina to both Malcolm Jenkins and Chris Long, and they said that the wins early on were like insurance policies that they bought for when the weather gets cold, for when the competition gets tougher. Here we are in November. It's about to get cold. It's about to get windy. This is when playoff caliber teams make their push. The Eagles happen to be doing it against fellow playoff caliber competition. I think they take care of business against the Cowboys, which leaves them open to only needing to split against the Rams and the Seahawks to control their own destiny for home field in the postseason. But I think that the real season begins on Sunday night.